Good morning. Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Wherever you're watching this from, welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful, sunny Monday, arguably the hottest summer ever recorded in history, in sporting history. But it might prove to be, from the things I see, the longest summer we've experienced. The action, the passion, the exhilaration, and all the entertainment that has been brought from the Euros to the Olympics. Finally, the creme de la creme, the upper echelon, the big boys, the stars are back. The Premier League returned with a banger upon bangers. Absolutely nothing has changed. The guard is still being held by Manchester City. They are still the team to beat. Arsenal, once again, looked quite promising in the beginning, but like we always say, it takes a longer period. By June, July, May, you can be champion, even by November. But when the fourth quarter comes, that is when true champions show character. So no need to be carried away. No need to, stir up the pot. It was a good week. It was a good return for football and soccer. The exhibition, Manchester City beat Chelsea 2-0 at Stamford Bridge. That was the blockbuster marquee game for the weekend leading up into it. Nothing has changed. Like I said, there was no surprise there. And you see, it's gotten to the point where, as a Chelsea fan, I don't want to be a broken record. So you just have to see. It is clear for all, we need a striker. It would change a lot. You cannot blame the players because they were brought. You understand me? They were brought. If you are sitting there and I am worth 1 million, yet you tell me I'm worth 100 million, of course I'll take your 100 million. So you cannot even criticize the players too much. That is what they can do. The midfield, the middle, Moise Caicedo and Enzo Fernandez. Enzo Fernandez has to do more. He has to do more if he is a boss player that he perceives himself to be. You cannot just pass the ball to the wings and cross the ball in with no clinical idea behind it, just passing the ball. Anybody can do that. So, like I said, nothing has changed. Man City beat Chelsea 2-0. Arsenal looked very good against Wolves. Bukayo Saka getting on the score sheet for Arsenal. Kai Havertz, a Chelsea player who iron sharpens iron. So you need certain caliber of players in the team to make other players better. Kai Havertz, like a new player. Mateo Kovacic, a former Chelsea player, also sold lastly because they don't do anything. There's no common sense behind anything. It's like everything is done in a rush. Mateo Kovacic got the goal for Man City, and then Haaland got the first goal. So all in all, if you watch it, I watch all the games, nothing has changed. Brentford beats Crystal Palace. Ivan Toney is not playing because of transfer negotiations. It might be a conflict for him to be on the field or get injured. Chelsea needs a striker. We either get Ivan Toney or you can get Victor Osimhen. Romelu Lukaku is still a Chelsea player, training with the camp. Kepa Arrizabalaga, the goalkeeper, very international, renowned goalkeeper. He went on loan with Real Madrid. So if we take out the politics, we have some players who are better than what we are experiencing. Conor Gallagher's move to Atletico Madrid is still stalling. We don't know whether he's going to go or yet because of financial fair play clauses. João Félix is in the mix. So it is just Chelsea. It's a mix. If you want to describe it in a very, it's a mixed bag of just some goodies, but also some rotten apples. It's just, thank you for tuning into Assam Sports on this beautiful Monday. The Premier League returned this weekend with action and exhilaration. Satisfaction was guaranteed. Manchester United also unveiled, should I say, in quite a stellar nature. very United-esque of Alex Ferguson, a dying minute goal by Xerxes. They have made a good move. I saw him for Bologna. He was convincing, but the Premier League is a different beast. And he has proven that he has what it takes to rise to the big stage. He got their goal. Manchester United beat Fulham. I mean, but you can also say Fulham was very bad with their finishing. If it was a different team, they could have won it today. More games are going on a Monday special where Tottenham Hotspur and Postecoglou ball is back. And Postecoglou's Tottenham Hotspur playing against the newly promoted Leicester City. Leicester City, Enzo Maresca led them to the Premier League. Reason how he got the job with Chelsea. Leicester City is playing against Tottenham Hotspur. They were relegated last season, the season before, but they came right back. This is what you call a proper bounce back. Leicester City are back in the Premier League and they are playing against Tottenham Hotspur and Postecoglou ball. Heung-min Song, that will be a great one to watch. Yes. What is your evaluation so far of the season? It's very early days, so no need to get carried away. I am more concerned for Chelsea in the long run. I don't even care about this game. Being beat by Man City is no news. I mean, nobody thought Chelsea could beat them, even though we could have if we had some finishers in the team. It's so clear for all to see. So yes, we passed the ball around. There were moments in there where, like, Chelsea played good. You understand me? Should I say Romeo Lavia is a bright spot? He is definitely, I mean, but it's something we already knew. But Romeo Lavia is one player. And the formation where he played Cole Palmer today, you have to play Cole Palmer in a sweeper role. That is his best. You cannot play Cole Palmer like, you cannot give him a defined definition because he cannot be defined. You have to leave Cole Palmer to just sweep around that area. Play a striker. I mean, look, anybody with any common football sense will tell you that if Chelsea gets a striker today, if Chelsea gets an international proper striker, I mean, that's over. Then we have to think about defense. And that is also a conversation that is there. But at least I come from a theory that if you play football soccer, you have to score goals. So our defense is not the best. Chelsea defense is leaking too. If you know, you know. We need reinforcements there. But at this point in time, with the style we are playing, we can score more. So you score more, you concede some. Who cares? At the end of the day, that is the style of play that we have to develop now. Thank you for tuning into Assembly Sports. Leicester City is playing against Tottenham Hotspur today in a Monday Madness action of Assembly Sports. The Premier League is back. The Premier League, the upper echelon, the creme de la creme. Who do you tip to win it? Arsenal is always going to be the one that got away. Manchester City look like they haven't skipped the beat for the first game, coming off a Community Shield victory. So all across board, this week there were tired legs. You know, there were tired legs in there. So you cannot rate this game too much. Just the first game. What's going to happen? Thank you for tuning into Assembly Sports. Thank you for your love and support. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0. New music available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. We're going to channel coming soon. This is Assembly Sports. Have a wonderful week. Goodbye, thank you.